guys, so today I'm going to do a video on my favorite baby products, Reborn related, and I thought that this would be a fun video to do to show you the things that I love to use with my Reborns, and maybe you will get some ideas. So here we go. So the first thing I want to show you is our car seat. This is the Chico brand car seat. I'm not sure of the model, but there's the brand. And I actually got this from Craigslist, and it was only $50, and it was brand new. The people that sold it to me, their child only used it like twice because she had acid reflux and she didn't like to be in the car seat. So slammin' deal. As you can see, it's brand new, and I love this car seat because I do love taking my babies out, and I also have the stroller. So I guess altogether it's the travel system that is my favorite thing, but I absolutely love this, and so does Dexter. And I love to be able to take my Reborns out with me and take them with me where I go. So it's definitely one of those, if you can, one of those things that are definitely a added bonus to owning a Reborn, because you can take them places and pretend like you are a mommy and get all the aws, but you don't have to worry about the spit up and crying and diarrhea and all that stuff. And so Brinley was in here last, and so I have this little toy for her. It's really annoying though, because when you like walk with her, oh, it twinkles and stuff, and it's really obnoxious. So I usually keep it like in here with her instead of having it like out like that. But I still love this car seat, and it's really easy to use and adjust. And yeah, I'm just a huge fan of the Chico brand. And I will definitely be saving this for when I have a baby someday. So it's in perfect condition. So yeah, I will do a stroller review for you guys if you're interested in that as a separate video, so you guys can see everything about it. So that is the Chico stroller slash car seat travel system that I love. So our next favorite thing is our boppy, and this is a boppy from Nursing Pillow. It's called a nursing pillow, but I call it a boppy. It could be called either or. But I actually like this boppy more than the real boppy because it's smaller, and I like the minky feeling of it. And I got this, I only had to pay like shipping, and it was only like $15, and I'm sure you can look it up, but it's super duper soft, and someone's texting me. I love the minky fabric, and it's such a pretty bright yellow, and it's gender neutral. I actually think I want to order another one in like a slate blue maybe, or like a gray, and have an extra one, because I only use this one. I never use my real boppy. So yeah, that is another one of our favorite things. Another favorite of mine is our Rock and Play, and I love this thing. It is perfect size for a single baby, and they're just so cute. You can strap them in, and it makes for amazing posing for pictures, because it's just enough depth to like look really good, and you can take it anywhere, so you could move it to where the light is, and you can also fold it up really easily for storage. So I really, really love this for posing with babies. You can probably fit two in here, and it's a really, really awesome way to display babies if you don't have a lot of space in your room or house or wherever you live. So I got this one in pink just because I was tired of having to be responsible and get gender neutral. And I just love it because it's pink and girly and adorable and so cute. So it also vibrates, but I don't have batteries in it right now. But yeah, that's another thing that we really love. I also love my bouncer, obviously. It's a great place to store babies, and for pictures, definitely. It elevates them enough and gives them enough of an angle. And this one is a very gender neutral. I've had it for a long time, and as you can see, Maggie fits pretty good in it. So we love, love, love our bouncer. And of course, I realize that this is not possible for everybody. I am very blessed and fortunate enough to be able to have a crib. So that's why it's one of my favorite things. But obviously, a lot of people can't, either financially or space-wise, can't have one. So I just thought to put it in there because it is one of my favorite things. So as you can see, some of my babies are out because I was using them as props or doing pictures or videos or something about with them, so I don't have all of them in here, but as you can see, it's pretty spacious and fits a lot of babes. So I love, love, love this, and I got this at IKEA, and it was only like 66, 67, around there. But I love the detail, the scalloped edges type thing, and I love that it's white and just very simple and pretty, and so one of my favorite things for sure. Okay guys, moving into like blankets and comfort items. I love muslin blankets. They're really big and stretchy. And this one I got from Carter's, obviously, and it came in a 2-pack. And the other one has, I think, hearts on it. Or no, flowers, I think. But they're so cute and really big, very easy to swaddle, and they're very light knit. And they can be expensive, but I wanted to show you that I got these from Marshall's, and they're a 2-pack, and they were only $6. So, and they were 20. So you can get a deal on them, and they're very, very nice, huge blankets. They're really nice to cover up car seats when you're taking your baby out. You actually have enough to cover the car seat and wrap it around the handle so you don't have to, like, you know, sacrifice either side of the car seat to be covered. So that's really nice. And they have fun prints, and they're just really cute. And I actually have been known to use one when I'm sleeping at night because I get really hot. And so I like to just cover up my arms. And so I'll use like one of these to cover up my arms with. And it gives you just enough warmth where you're okay, but you're not gonna get overheated, which is the point for newborns. So love, love, love the swaddling blankets. Another blanket I love is the thicker, soft velour blanket with the solid color on the other side, mainly because I like to drape these over my boppy or my bouncer or something as a nice background for pictures or videos. And so it's nice that you can have the print on one side, but also have the solid color on the other side to, you know, take pictures and not distract from the baby with the print. And this one has a little lion on it. And they're very, very cute. Another brand that I really love is Blankets and Beyond. And they're usually at Ross or TJ Maxx or Marshall's or any of those kind of like outlet stores. And I got this one from Target, and it's by Tiddlywinks. And Tiddlywinks is another one of my favorite brands. And I have a lot of blankets from them. And Serco actually is coming out with more cute patterns and blankets with the solid colors. But this is one of my favorites because it's like a cream color, and it's very gender neutral, and it's nice to have. So this is one of my favorite things to use for backgrounds for pictures or videos with my reborns. I also have been loving the really cute security blankets, and this is one of them. It's just a blanket with a little stuffed animal attached to it. And they are so cute and so fun to pose with the babies. And they have lots and lots of different kinds. This one is by Graco, but we have tons and tons of them. And this one, I think, is the Sweet Little Ladybug line. Not all Walmarts carry it, but they also have a Monster one that I also bought. But I just had this one on hand, and so I thought to show you this one. But this one's super cute. The colors aren't showing up real great on camera because it's like a pink color, but it's still really, really cute, and the opposite side is just a plain pink. But they're just fun to pose with your babies and have them snuggle up to them, and
It's just, they're just really cute and a lot of fun to have.
So the next thing I love are onesies, as you guys know, especially if you have a full-limbed or full-legged baby. I think onesies are so cute and so easy to put on and adorable. So I have these Just One You ones, and for some reason onesies are so much more fun to buy when they're in size newborn. I don't know why. They're just so cute and little, but I got these for Jackson, and this one with this one, and it's just a 3-pack, and they're so cute, and I like how Carter's is very slim fit, and they fit the Reborns really well, and I think it's definitely a necessity, but I will be doing a video on that. But this is one of my favorite things, and I also wanted to show you the preemie size. This is child of mine, so it's the Walmart brand of onesie, but they're still super cute, and you can see how much smaller they are. But these were for Theo, and they fit him perfectly. He is Meredith by Bonnie Brown. He's about 16 inches, so if you have a small preemie, these work really well. And also these ones by Babies R Us, these are size preemie, and they fit pretty well. They're a little bit wider than the Carters, but as you can see, they're a lot shorter, so if you have a more wider baby, then these will probably do you well. I noticed that the leg holes were a little bit big for him, so you could see his cloth. He has full legs, but you could see the cloth through his diaper, so that's something that you might want to consider. But these are long enough so where it covers it, but yeah, we love these. And I'm sorry about the color. Oh my gosh, it's starting to get light out or dark out, so it's starting to get dark out, so I excuse the lighting, but I just wanted to show you what they look like on Theo. As you can see, they fit him pretty perfectly. I mean, I can't really ask for anything more in a onesie for a little preemie guy like him, but I just think they look so sweet, and they fit really good. So you can see how tiny he is, but yeah, we love those onesies, and we love our Boppy, don't we? So going along with the whole onesie theme, I love to put a white onesie on underneath my baby's clothing just to protect their cloth in case the clothes rub off. And if the baby has full limbs, it's nice to have this underneath in case the clothes rub off on their vinyl that isn't covered, you know. So it also adds a little bit of bulk to the baby, so if the clothes are too big, it adds a little bit of buffer, if you will, for it to fit a little bit better. So this is the Gerber brand. It's newborn size, and it fits really well. I also really love the Carters because they're obviously cut the same as the Carters onesies, so they fit really well. But I really love having a onesie on underneath their clothes just as an added protection for them. So this is another thing that we're loving right now besides Gymboree. We love Gymboree. But I love these up to 5-pound sleepers because they fit Maggie really well. And newborn size is a bit too big, except for if it's in that layette set where they're kind of slim fit. But these fit really well, and they're obviously super cute. This is the up to 5 pounds, and I apologize about the coloring. It looks really bad, but yeah, these fit really well, especially in the feet because they're so tiny. But I like how it has like the shorter legs because her legs are bent up, one of them is, and so it fits around her knee really well. So I really like these for Maggie, who is a Sirsha kit. And also I believe that if you wash this, it might shrink enough to fit like a baby Theo size, possibly. I'm not sure. Don't quote me on that. But yeah, I thought to give it a try, but without being washed, these fit about 18 inches really well. Since it is finally getting a little bit cooler at night, not in the daytime in Florida, but at night and in our house, because I like to keep the AC up pretty low, but I love these soft velour sleepers. This one is Prim's, and I particularly love it for Prim because she is so cuddly in this thing. Oh my gosh. I want to hold her all day long because she's so snuggly in it. But it's super thick and warm, and it just makes the baby so much more cuddly. And I love that they kind of add a little bit of bulk to the baby, so they make them a little bit heftier and snugglier. And since it is getting colder, it's nice to have a baby to cuddle in one of these. So I love that it's the zipper, and these zippers don't like bulge up, you know how some do. It's so soft that it lays flat, and that's what I like, and it has the thick cuffs. But this one has like breakfast foods on it, and it's super cute, and it fits her really well. So I've been loving these on her. Also, since it is getting colder, I love jackets on the babies. They look so cute. And in particular, I love this jacket. It's so cute. I got it at Old Navy last year. And it's just a plain white cream color. And it is like the Sherpa fabric. And it has a little hand warmer things. And it has the little bear ears. It's so cute. It's size 0 to 3 months. And I love for little girls to put like a little bow right here, like a pink bow, just so it make it a little bit girlier. But it works for boys or girls. And the babies are so snuggly in this and really cute. And it's fun to take them out in this little jacket. I'm going to have to try to find another one. I want to find another one in pink and another one in brown because they're so cute. But yeah, like I said, it's Old Navy, and they have really cute jackets. I have also been loving these boots. Look at how cute they are lined up. I love boots on babies. They're so cute, especially these for Prim. She looks so adorable in them. These are a size 4 because of the calf area. She has kind of a bigger calf, and so I thought to get a 4, and they fit her really well. But these are just plain little, like, UGG imitation boots. And these two are size newborn boots. And these are just so cute. Little bow in the back. They're so adorable, and they're perfect for the upcoming winter. Even though it doesn't get too cold in Florida, I think it gets out about into the 40s at the coldest, which is sad because I love cold weather. But these ones I think could be for a boy or a girl. But I think they're supposed to be for a boy, but we could make it work. So, yeah, I've been really loving these boots for Prim and the little ones because they're just so cute. Some of my other favorite things are these kind of quirky hats. I love the non-Gerber kind of hats that have faces on them, something that you don't really see every day. And so this one is from Gymboree. It's a little owl. You've seen Brinley wear it. And you've seen Kaylee wear this one. This is her little bunny hat, which is adorable. And I love these. They're so cute. And then I got this hat, which is supposed to support breastfeeding. Obviously, we don't have that problem. But I just thought that it was really cute and funny. And it fits Brinley really well and the other babies. And I mostly got these hats for Kaylee because she has that kind of goofy expression on her face. And so I think funny hats really suit her. So I got some funny ones for her, but this one just cracks me up because it's supposed to look like a breast, but very funny. I got this one off of Etsy, and Etsy is my best friend for handmade items, and they just look really cute. So I really love funny hats. Oh, and I also found this one for Theo. This was in the toy section for the Walmart's version of American Girl, and you can see how tiny it is. And it fits him pretty good. I'm going to get him a couple more different ones. But this one's obviously an owl. So I really love like the funny, weird hats that really bring out the baby's personalities for sure. We also love cloth diapers, even though I don't put them on the babies enough. I love them. I got this one a long time ago. I think I got this on Zoe's first Target trip. It's been a long time, but this one has little spaceships and outer space type of theme, and the inside's super soft. And then we got this one with Kaylee, and it's just a really pretty aqua blue color that matches her little shirt that she came in. But we really love these, and I'm looking to get a couple more because they're just really cute, and they do fill out the babies a bit better. But
Yeah, they're just really cute, and the fun prints are nice with just like a t-shirt. I also wanted to mention with these cloth diapers that these ones are really expensive in the store, but you can go on to eBay, and I believe there is a seller that's in Japan or China, I believe, and you can get like 5 or 6 of them for like a couple dollars, but they don't have like the inserts or anything, but obviously you don't need that if you have a reborn because they don't go potty on themselves. But if you wanted just for like aesthetics, then that would be the place to go. So if you just type in like cloth diaper and then go from lowest to highest, including shipping, and kind of weed through like the extra fillers and stuff like that, then you'll definitely find what you're looking for. So yeah, really cute. And you can also go on Etsy if you want to spend a little bit more. They do have prints. They're not made like this, most of them. They're more like this, but they have like the patterns like these ones. And so that would be good. I think I want to get one that has Velcro on it, because these buttons really confuse me, because I don't have kids, so I don't know how they work. But yeah, so I think that that would be the way to go if you wanted to buy a diaper without spending a ton of money. Going on with the diapers, we love the Johnson's Baby Powder to put in their diapers because it makes them smell really good and they smell like real babies. And it's just fun to add. This is the cornstarch one, and it's soothing baby powder, aloe, and vitamin E. So real nice, and it smells really good. So we always love to put this one in their diapers. It's also really good for powdering your silicones so the clothes don't stick to them and you can really damage them and rip them if you're not careful. So this is another thing to use to powder them so you don't make a fool of yourself by ripping your baby. So that's nice to have too. So these are our favorite bottles for little Theo. I obviously like these because they fit his face perfectly because they are tiny 2 ounces, but this one is a little safari theme. I have a couple of them. I got these from the Dollar Tree, and they were, of course, a dollar each, and the nipple is really tiny and easy to seal, and so if you have a little one, then this would be good for them. And I have the formula a little bit thicker than I normally would because preemies, you know, might need a thicker formula for extra nutrients. At least that's what I pretend. So, yeah, I have that one for him. And then my favorite bottle is the Nook. I also love the Playtex nursers, but I don't have one that's full right now, so I didn't include it. But I love how these fit on the baby's faces, and the patterns are just so cute. This one was a sippy cup, but we turned it into a bottle. And it just has butterflies and flowers on it. It's very sweet, and we like it a lot. And we have this sippy cup. This one's Collins. It has apple juice in it. And I love how these handles are really easy for the toddlers to hold. And since he is a smiling baby, he can put this in his mouth so it looks like he's drinking it, which is really cute. And Prim has one that's pink and purple. I have to seal it, though. But, yeah, it makes it really easy for them to hold with the little handles on the sides. So we really love this for the toddlers. And this is my favorite fabric softener to put in the baby's bottles. It smells really good. I personally left the cap open for a few days outside, and I put cellophane over it and poked holes in it so it could still kind of vent a little bit and not get bugs in it and stuff, just so it kind of reduced the smell a little bit because it was strong when it first opened it, but now it's not bad at all. But this is what it looks like, and I wanted to show you, this is what it looks like in the bottle. I didn't add anything except for a little bit of water, but it has the formula type of hue to it. It's a little yellow, it's not stark white, and as you can see, it clears really nicely, and it looks very realistic. So it's really easy to make and not have to add anything to it. You can add vanilla and all those other things if you want to make the tone a little bit different. But for me, that works fine. It's still thick enough to be formula. And, yeah. But this is one that I made. And before I got it, and you can tell the difference in color. This one, the Nook is a lot yellower. It's supposed to resemble breast milk, I think, in this one's formula. But yeah, I still really like this, and it's nice and thick, and it looks a lot like formula. So yeah, and it's, even though it is strong, it does smell really nice.
So these are the favorite toys of the moment. We have this little guy, Elephant. He is squeaky. And he is by, I believe, Infantino, maybe? I can't remember. But I got him from Target. And he's super duper cute. And he's so fun to pose with the babies. The cats love this guy. They love to sniff him. And then they pounce on him to make him squeak. It's really cute. I might have to buy another one for them. Oh, it's by Infantino. There it goes. So, yeah. But he's super duper adorable. We love him. And I also have some links because I love to pose these with the babies because they're really easy for open hand babies to hold on to and look like that they're playing. And you can put them through the closed fist babies to make it look like they maybe fell asleep or something like that holding them. And so they're really easy to pose. And then also the keys are fun to have them hold because they're really thick and chunky. And I like to pose Kaylee with one of them in her mouth, and it works really good for her. So I think they're really adorable. And then I also picked out these little Fisher-Price princesses. They're by Little People. And this one's Prims, and she has another one. I can't remember which one it is. Maybe Aurora? No, this is Aurora. What's the other one? I can't remember. But it's in the Taking Prim to Target video. But I like these because they're chunkier and she can hold on to them with her open hands. And they're easy to pose with, and they're really light, so I can like lift up her arms and make it look like she's playing with them. So they're really, really cute. And if I had a daughter, I would definitely buy these for her. Especially like the play sets because they're so cute. But obviously we have no use for them now. So... anyway, these are really cute, and they're really easy for a reborn to hold, and that's why we like them so much. And these are my favorite things to use on the reborn's hair. This Johnson's No More Tangles is what I use for their hair, and it smells so good. I love it. I've used it on my hair before, no joke. It smells that good. And it detangles, yeah, but it also re-moisturizes the mohair, and it really helps with the frizziness. So... in particular, if you have a baby with fuzzy mohair, with curly hair, then I would recommend this because the curly or wavy mohair can get frizzy super fast. So you want to make sure that you moisturize it. But this is what I use. I'm sure there's a knockoff version, but this is only like $2, so it's not a big deal for us to buy. But as you can see, I've used quite a bit of it because a little goes a long way. I've used maybe a little bit more than half or less than half. So I still have a long way to go. But what I do is I put this in a smaller spray bottle. So it's like that big. So it's easier to tote it around or put it in the diaper bag or something like that. But yeah, that's what we use. And then this is my favorite brush. I'm not sure where I got it from. I can't remember. But the bristles are so soft, and it's good for Reborn's hair. So... we really like that. And this is my favorite comb to use. It's by Conair. I got it in a double pack. I keep one for me and one for them. And it really helps to separate the hair and make sure that you don't miss any knots. And what I do is after I'm done, I take this brush and I comb it, see, through this one to get all the mohair out of this. And then I can just pull the mohair out if it does come out. It normally doesn't. But if I have any stray hairs, then I'll usually just like comb it through like this and make sure I pull all of the hair out so this brush doesn't get dingy. And so that makes it really easy. I also like to use toothbrushes for the fine baby hair. But I didn't bring it out. So that's an idea for you if you're looking for a brush if you have a baby with teeny tiny hairs. So, if you know me, you know that I love bows on baby girls. I am addicted.
So I had to include these. These aren't my favorites, but I just wanted to give you an example. I love flowers on babies, and these are ones that I've made. I made this one, and it's super duper floppy and soft, and it looks really cute on the babies. And then I made this one, the black elastic. And then you know me and my love of cupcakes, so I had to make this one. And it looks super adorable. And then I love these little clips, especially for Kaylee, because headbands don't look good on her. For some reason, she's got that curly hair, and it just makes her head look really misshapen and odd. Bless her. So I decided to get these, and she has a magnet in her head, thank God, for bows. And so I just slap these on her head, and they look great. And you can also clip them into a baby's hair if they don't have a magnet. But these clip onto your arm hair. Like, they're so amazing. And we really, really, really like them. The clip is very tiny. So, yeah, we got that. And it's one of our favorites. And then this one I got at Once Upon a Child. And it has the other kind of clip. I wanted to show you both. But, yeah, so I love these tiny little clips. I think they're so cute and dainty. And so, especially if you have a little baby, it'd be cute to have these. So, they're just super adorable. So these are my favorite types of passies and clips. Not these in particular, but I like the brand. So these are MAMs right here, and they're the 0 month size. And I like these because they fit Theo's face. Not particularly well, but because he's so tiny, but they do fit him reasonably better than the other ones, so we'll take it. And we also love the Avents because they're flat and they fit really nicely on the baby's faces. So this one, I believe, is Zoe's. Lost my train of thought there. So very cute. Oops, it's upside down. But I really like them for babies with chubby cheeks because they fit really well. And also we love the Nooks because they fit perfectly on babies' faces. They are slightly curved, so they work really well. And these are my favorite passy clips. They're by Ulubulu, and you can get them at Target. And they just have fun, exciting little prints on them, very bright and colorful. And you can use an attachment that you get with the MAMS passy clips to use for the MAMS that don't have the ring to clip on. So I just thought to show you that. And you can also lark head this through just to hold on to that. And it's just really simple. And I love, love, love the patterns. And I love that they're now sold at Target because at Bye Bye Baby they're like a dollar more. So I'm happy to get them. And I love, love, love the prints. They're so cute. I wanted to show you what the passy looks like on Ollie. But as you can see, it fits really well. There's not much gap there, which is nice. This one fits him really well. So this is his passy. Nobody else uses it because it fits him so perfectly. Okay, guys, this is the last of my favorites. I have these magnets. And these are itty bitty itty. I don't even know if they'll focus. But they're tiny, tiny little magnets, as you can see. And these are good for hair bows, I've noticed. And they're also really good for passies for preemies. I used one of them on this passy for Theo, and since they're so thin, it's easy to work with a preemie passy. I wouldn't use it for a normal size baby because the passies fall off because there's not enough strength there. But with a, there we go, you can see how tiny they are. With a hair bow, it's really light and not a lot of weight, and so this would be perfect for them. So I have a ton that I need to make, but and then I love E6000 for reborning, well, not reborning because I don't reborn, but for reborning accessories, if you will. I particularly like these tubes because sometimes when you open up a new tube of E6000, it oozes everywhere. And then when you go to close the tube, it glues itself shut. And if you guys know, this stuff is strong. So I would rather lose a little tube like this than the whole $6 tube. So I have this, and I really, really like it. And it's just basically a single use for me because I keep it. I use it until I can't use it anymore for making passies or headbands or anything like that. So I really like these small things. And you can get them, I think, at Walmart. You can get them at Target. And I got these from either Michael's or Joann's. So I think they come in a 4-pack. And 4 or 5-pack. Probably 4-pack. But these are really nice to have. And these are the magnets that I use for passies. As you can see, they're thicker. You can get them thinner, but I think the thinner you go, the less strength there is. And so I wanted them to be strong. So I got these off of eBay from a seller in China, I believe. But they came really, really quickly. So if you type in like Reborn Magnet, I'm sure you'll get a bunch of hits. But these are the ones that I use. They're pretty big. So yeah, these are the ones that I use. And they're pretty, pretty strong. So that's good. But yeah, guys, that is all of my favorites. Look at all this. And I hope that you enjoyed this video and get some ideas for your babies through my favorites. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. And I'll talk to you later. Bye.